The affected residents are from the learning sites of Kamina, Kabukanga, Rebigongoro, Kitebere, Ndaiga, and others. They accuse Willy Ramojo, a business tycoon from Kabale and Rogers Kwezi, an associate of Ramojo, of evicting them from their land. The victims have asked the Parliamentary Committee on Infrastructure to intervene in the matter. We have lost a lot of our land that we have lived on for over three decades. Our church was demolished. We are tortured, beaten. Our wives were raped while others are killed. There is a lot of corruption in our district. The Kagadi LC5 chairperson, Nyosia Ndibwami, extorted money from me, promising to come on ground with district leaders to help us. But since then, he switched off his phone. I was raped by a soldier at gunpoint, and when my husband intervened to rescue me, he was arrested by Ndaiga police and imprisoned. We want justice from the higher authorities. My beloved pregnant wife, identified as Rebecca Masika, 36, was shot dead innocently by a soldier hired by Willy Ramojo from Marine Protection Unit on Lake Albert Shores. I was left with dependents. I need help from the higher authorities. During the Parliamentary Committee on Physical Infrastructure, Barnabas Tinkasimire, the Wuyaga West MP, who led a team representing the affected Ndaiga residents, told the committee that Willy Ramojo, who owns about 12 square kilometers of land on the shores of Lake Albert, has evicted over 10,000 residents.
The committee heard the atrocities being committed by those people on the ground, and they have agreed they are going to go on the ground, and they will not tolerate that nonsense of the so-called powerful. That's why they were fighting, taking me to court to make sure that they stop this process.
Tony Awani, the vice chairperson of the Parliamentary Committee on Physical Infrastructure, together with the committee members, comforted the victims. They promised to summon all those implicated. The committee also recommended site visits to assess the extent of the allegations.
How would somebody in his very same mind erase the whole of a church, a Catholic church, St. Rita? This is despicable. We are not going to allow this kind of impunity to continue in this country. This country is governed by rules of laws. This country is governed by the whims of the law of justice.
While talking to our reporter on phone, the accused denied all the allegations. They revealed that they have land titles and sale agreements they made with the residents on the shores of Lake Albert. MP Barnabas is just politicking. He incites violence by damaging our fenced land we bought from the residents. We have sales agreements and there is no cause for alarm. Story compiled by Andrew Musinguzi for the news in Kagadi.